How's it going, everybody? It's Kevin here once again, giving you another gameplay commentary. Well, actually, today it's just standard commentary. When you think about it, cause it's just gonna be me, background, swirliness in the background, all that good stuff. Because today I want to talk about the most popular playlist in Halo right now. Now, before we continue on with this commentary, I want you to pause the video and then think about the top five playlists you think are going on right now in Halo. Where are the most populated playlists in Halo right now? Just listen to the comment section down below. I'm waiting. Okay, so for me, I would say my top five, but this is not in particular order. I just think the top five most populated playlists in my mind would certainly be Slayer. Warzone would have to be up there. Maybe even Quick Play, because that's like the casual Slayer playlist. I know Super, and then Super Fiesta. I know those are really popular. Those would probably be the five that I would probably put up there and on my list. But here is the actual list. We'll start from the bottom. And then we'll go to the top here. Okay, so starting out at the bottom here, and drum roll please. The least popular playlist in Halo 5 is Griffball. Yes, Griffball is actually the least popular playlist. I think this kind of maybe this game I probably just struggled because it hasn't really updated a whole lot since it was initially released. So I can see that why that game was not being played a whole lot. And I think it also has a big issue with booting as well, because and betrayals, because obviously betrayals and Griffball, it's a major thing, and I think that's a big issue with that game mode. Plus, I enjoy Griffball, it's fun, but as a standalone playlist, that's kind of a stretch, I feel, for that game mode. I think it'd be best if you mix it in with Action Sack. That's just my opinion, though. Second least popular playlist in Halo 5 is Halo WC Free For All. I can understand this because as someone who's decent at the game, I recently got to Diamond 2, I believe, or Diamond 1 in Free For All, something like that. It seems like whenever I finish top 3, I'm instantly put up against a champion or a professional Halo player. And for me to get matched up against those guys, the playlist probably is a little low. So I understand that too. And plus, competitive playlists don't necessarily do the best when it comes to your standard game modes. Now, or the public, I should say. Now, this was actually a little surprising for me. Third least favorite, Warzone Assault. I personally really enjoy it. To me, it's kind of like putting Rush into Halo. Maybe it's just because it just feels like it's a smaller version of Warzone. And it's basically a lesser experience of what the full game of Warzone has to offer. So that'd be one reason why it's not played as much, but you know, whatever. Moving forward, we have Breakout. Understandable, in my opinion, because Breakout really isn't that fun. Then you have Mythic Warzone Firefight. I think that's only because it's down this low, just because it's only on the weekends. And then you have Team Snipers. Then you have the Halo WC team playlist on that one, which is surprisingly low. It's the professional player, so it's got to have a little bit lower player base. Right above that is Action Sack, actually. And then you have Team Doubles, Team Arena, the Halo 3 throwback playlist, SWAT, Infection, Legendary Warzone Firefight, Big Team Battle, and then now we're getting to the top five here. Is Quick Play, it's number 5. Understandable, it's like the... To me, it's probably the most fair version of Halo to play, and with the recent matchmaking tweaks that are coming to this playlist very soon, they're looking to make this even more fair for probably solo queue players, which is going to be great for me, because a lot of times I'm playing solo. The fourth most popular playlist in Halo 5 is Warzone, and then number 3, you have Heroic Warzone Firefight, number 2, Slayer, and number 1, Super Fiesta, which is actually kind of surprising. I wouldn't expect Super Fiesta to be number 1, but I can understand why, just because it's one of the few times you get a chance to use these awesome wreck weapons without really having to worry about, you know, wasting cards or any stress about doing well with them, because, or just like a lot of times, a lot of people don't have access to these weapons quite yet, and so this is their opportunity to play around with them, which is super fun. And also, removing weapon spawns off the map makes it so then players don't have to have knowledge of how to play the game. They kind of just hop in, whatever they have, they blow stuff up, and it's kind of fun. It's understandable. Though, it seems like with that play, it's kind of like whoever has a rocket launcher does the best. I was expecting Slayer to be at least top 3, for my opinion, on that one. Heroic Warzone Firefight. rather surprising that it's up there that high. I find Warzone Firefight to be a little shoehorned into Halo 5. But and then, of course, you have Warzone, which I was kind of expecting to be top three in there as well. But yeah, whatever. But the reason why I want to talk about all these different playlists and why it's important to know the rankings of these playlists, because 343 pays attention to this stuff. There was a video back in 2015, Kevin Franklin, who is no longer with 343, he started his own game company, but he put up a video on a DICE conference about him looking about the 343 analyzing the user data of Halo and trying to mold Halo 5 into the game it became based off of information from like Halo 4 and previous input from previous games as well. So 343, it will be taking note about what people are playing, how often they're being played, these game modes are being played, and how to tailor Halo 6 to best suit the needs of the player base for what's being played by, you know, everybody right now. Obviously, I think the Halo WC playlist is something that is always going to be sticking with Halo. It's something that you're going to always have to have, like a little bit of a competitive playlist, at least to get those players' needs out. Even though they're a small, they're a minority group of players, though it's something that should be there for players who want to kind of step up their game a little bit higher, which I certainly appreciate because I think Halo's always kind of roots in as a competitive like shooter, even though most of the playlists that people like to play are more casual. But you know, you have Slayer and then you have Warzone, which is a little bit more casual, but still kind of like sweaty in a way, and quick play as well. Being in the top five, so it's like three out of the five I would say are much more the competitive like game mode. Even though Warzone, you'd call it casual, but the idea of it is the get more kills, do better than other people kind of thing. That's what I mean, it's competitive. But leave in the comment section down below, guys, what you think about this list, and what do you think 343 should do moving forward when it comes to all these different playlists that are in Halo, because we have, you know, a lot of, I feel like there's a bit of redundancy in the amount of playlists that are available in Halo 5, especially with the population being a little bit lower since the games have been out for 2.5 years. And, you know, we do have our classic playlist. We have our casual big battle playlist as well. Casual Slayer, which is finally back in the game. And then slight variations of what Slayer can be and stuff like that. And some, you know, wacky, fun, casual games as well. I feel like some of these can be reduced, but you know, let me know in the comment section below, guys, what you think about that stuff. And you can probably use that input in for the next video as well. But I think that's going to be it for me in this video, guys. I just want to let you know that, hey, these are the most popular players being played in Halo, and 343 is definitely taking note of this and will implement some of these, will take note of these and implement them into Halo 6 about how the gameplay and the playlist will be when that game is released. But thank you so much for watching. I greatly appreciate it. I'll catch you all in the next video. Peace out.